हेलो एवरीवन, माय नेम इज शोभित उनियाल एंड आई टीच इंडियन इकोनॉमी एंड साइंस एंड टेक्नोलॉजी एट वाजीराम एंड रवि. सो द टॉपिक ऑफ डिस्कशन टुडे वुड बी एलिमेंट्री पार्टिकल्स. फ्रेंड्स, अर्लियर वी ऑल नो दैट अर्लियर द साइंटिस्ट यूज टू बिलीव दैट एटम इज द स्मॉलेस्ट पार्टिकल दैट वी नो ऑफ दैट दे आर द बिल्डिंग ब्लॉक्स ऑफ द यूनिवर्स. वी यूज टू से दैट एटम कैनॉट बी फर्दर डिवाइडेड इंटू more simpler particles. We used to believe that atom is indivisible, but then later we got to know that the atom is further made up of still smaller particles called as, we call them as subatomic particles such as protons, neutrons and electrons. After that, we started believing that these protons, neutrons and electrons, they would be the smallest particles and they would be indivisible. But with the advancement of science, we again got to know that even these are not the smallest particles, as they are further made up of still smaller particles, which is called as elementary particles. So that protons and neutrons, now we know that even they are not the smallest particles themselves, because they are made up of still smaller particles called as elementary particles. For example, the constituents of protons and neutrons are the quarks, and quarks are the elementary particles. So today we will study about what these elementary particles are. Okay, talking about these subatomic particles, though the protons and neutrons are not the elementary particles, but here the electrons, they are the elementary particles. Okay, because electrons cannot be further broken down into more simpler particles. Electrons are the simplest particles themselves, but protons and neutrons are, they are not the simplest particles themselves. They are made up of still smaller particles called as the elementary particles. So now let's discuss what the elementary particles are. Elementary particles. Okay, so friends, elementary particles are the smallest particles themselves. That means they are not made up of any other smaller particles. They are the smallest particles or the simplest particles themselves. So in a way, we can say that elementary particles, they are the building blocks of the universe. The whole universe is made up of these elementary particles only. They constitute the whole universe, and they are the smallest particles themselves. And all the other particles and matter in the universe, they are made up of elementary particles only. Okay, so these are the smallest particles themselves. And we also know that the whole universe is made up of what? The universe is made up of either the matter or the energy. So all the matter around us is made up of matter or energy. They are made up of still smaller particles, which are called as the elementary particles. So now let us talk about the types of, what are the types of elementary particles? Types of elementary particles. So talking about the elementary particles can be broadly classified under these two types. We have the fermions and the bosons. Fermions, elementary particles can be broadly classified under fermions and the bosons. Fermions are the, they are the matter particles. Fermions are the matter particles. That means the whole matter in the universe is made up of elementary particles called as fermions. All the matter in the universe is made up of fermions, matter particles. Bosons are the force carrying, they are the force carrying particles, or you can call them as, they are the tiny bundles of, bosons are the tiny bundles of energy, because as we were discussing earlier that the whole universe is either made up of matter or either they are made up of energy. So we have elementary particles for matter, which are called as fermions. So all the matter particles, all the matter that we look around, matter, it is all made up of fermions. And the energy, for energy also we have the elementary particles for them. These are called as bosons. bosons are the force carrying particles, or you can say that they are the tiny bundles of energy. So let's first discuss about what these fermions are. So fermions, they are the elementary particles for the matter, and fermions are further divided into two types, which are quarks and leptons. So the matter, elementary particles for the matter, can further be divided into quarks and leptons. The quarks, they are of six types, and this type, we say that the quarks are of six types, or in other words we can say they are found in six flavors or the six types. And the type, their types are like this. Their names are up, down, top, bottom, strange, charm. So these are the six type of quarks we have, and these are their names: up, down, top, bottom, strange, charm. Talking about the leptons, so we have six type of leptons also, and the most popular lepton that you would have heard about is, it is the electron. Okay, so we were discussing earlier that electrons themselves are the elementary particles. Protons and neutrons are not the elementary particles, because they are further made up of, protons and neutrons are made up of quarks. They are made with the combination of quarks. But electrons are the elementary particles themselves. They are the smallest particles. You cannot further break down electron into more simpler particles. It is the smallest particle itself. Other leptons are electron, muon, tau. And electron, muon, tau. And then we have the neutrinos. Neutrinos are of three types: electron neutrino, muon neutrino, and tau neutrino. So these are the three kind of neutrinos we have. So these are the six type of leptons. So we have fermions. All the matter in the universe is made up of fermions. Fermions are of two types: quarks and leptons, which are of six types each. Quarks, six types. Leptons, six types. Electron is one of the, it belongs to the family of leptons only. So now, talking about the bosons, what are these? These are the, we are saying that these are the force carrying particle. And what does it mean? Actually, we have four fundamental forces in the nature. Okay, in the nature we have four fundamental forces, like strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, electromagnetic force, and gravitational force. And corresponding to each of these fundamental forces that we have in the nature, we have a corresponding force carrying particle also. Okay, so which is exchanged between the particles. So corresponding force carrying particle, which is responsible for that particular kind of interaction, okay, or the force. So for each of these four fundamental forces, we have a corresponding force carrying particle, which is nothing but a tiny bundle of energy. For example, the example of bosons are, we have first is gluon, which is responsible for the strong nuclear force. It is responsible, or which gives rise to a strong nuclear force. It is the gluon, is the force carrying particle, or a kind of boson. Another very popularly known boson is photon. Photon is responsible for electromagnetic force. Then third is W and Z bosons, which is responsible for the weak nuclear force. And fourth kind of boson is graviton, which is responsible for the gravitational force. But this graviton, it is not yet it is not yet discovered. Graviton, up till now, we have not been able to discover it through experiments. So this is what the whole universe is made up of. So the whole universe, we know that it is made up of either matter or energy. So the elementary particles of matter, they are called as fermions, which are divided into two types, quarks and leptons. And talking about the energy or the bundles of energy, we have four kind of force carrying particles corresponding to each of the four fundamental forces that we have in the nature. Like for the strong nuclear force, we have a corresponding particle gluon. For electromagnetic force, photon. For weak nuclear force, W and Z boson. For gravitational force, we have graviton. Okay, talking about very quickly, we can talk about these forces also. What is the role of this force? Like the strong nuclear force, it is the function of the strong nuclear force is to bind the quarks together. The strong nuclear force binds the quarks together, or it binds the nucleus together, because nucleus is made up of quarks only. Nucleus is made up of protons and protons and neutrons are made up of quarks. So in a way, we can say that the strong nuclear force keeps the nucleus together, or it binds the nucleus or the quarks together. And the particle which is responsible for that force carrying particle is gluon. Electromagnetic force, we know that electromagnetic force acts upon the electrically charged particles. Okay, and that the force carrying particle there is photon. Weak nuclear force, this weak nuclear force, it governs the particle decay. The particles that we have here, they also, the heavier particles, eventually they disintegrate into, they decay into the lighter particles here. And the force which is helping in that is called as weak nuclear force. So we can say it governs the particle decay. And the bosons responsible, or the force carrying particle responsible, there are W and Z bosons. Then gravitational force, it acts between the objects with mass. And for the gravitational force, the corresponding force carrying particle is graviton. Okay. So now a little bit about what is the differentiating factor between quarks and leptons. So talking about the quarks, so we can say, quarks, they are the elementary particles. Quarks are the elementary particles, and which they are the elementary particles, which and they are the constituents, and they are the building blocks for particles such as the quarks combine to form particles. They combine to form particles called hadrons. Okay, so this is a new word we have introduced here. So quarks, when the quarks combine, the particles that they form are called as hadron. Hadron, the word this hadron, you would have heard in the context of Large Hadron Collider. So that is this, in this context it is. Okay, so quarks, they combine to form particles called as hadrons. For example, protons and neutrons. Protons and neutrons are, they belong to the family of hadrons. Protons and neutrons are, they are not, okay, they are not the elementary particles, because they are made up of quarks. Like proton, it is made up of three quarks, which are two up quarks and one down quark combined to form proton. Neutron is made up of three quarks, two down and one up. This is what the neutron is made up of. So they are made up of three quarks. Quarks are the elementary particles, and they combine to form particles called as hadrons. Protons and neutrons are the popular examples of that. Fine. Quarks. One more very important point about quarks is that they are the only particles. Quarks are the only particles in the nature to have fractional. They are the only particles in the nature to have fractional charges. That is, their charges are in terms of fractions. Fractions like 1 by 3, plus, minus. The quarks have charges like this. Okay, they are the only particles in the nature to have fractional charges. Means their charges are, electrical charges are in terms of fractions, like 1 plus minus 1 by 3 or plus minus 2 by 3. And another important factor about the quarks is that they can experience all four fundamental forces of the nature. Means they can feel all four. Means they can feel strong nuclear force, weak nuclear force, gravitational force, electromagnetic force. All these four fundamental forces, they act upon the quarks. Fine? So this is the basics about quarks. And what is the differentiating factor between the quarks and the leptons? Leptons are also the elementary particles. But the differentiating factor between quarks and leptons is that leptons, they do not experience the strong nuclear force. Leptons can experience the other three fundamental forces. Okay, other three also if they are charged. Otherwise, only two. It means if they are not charged, they are not going to feel the electromagnetic force also. But if they are charged, the leptons which are having a charge on them, they can experience three fundamental forces, which are the electromagnetic force, weak nuclear force, and gravitational force. But the leptons do not feel the strong nuclear force. And this is the differentiating factor between quarks and the leptons. So when we talk about the nucleus of an atom, the nucleus contains what? Protons and neutrons. And protons and neutrons are made up of quarks. So in a way, nucleus is made up of quarks only. And what keeps the nucleus together? It is the strong nuclear force. And strong nuclear force acts only upon the quarks, but it will not act upon the leptons. That means electron is a kind of lepton. So electron is not going to feel the strong nuclear force. That is why electron, they reside outside the nucleus. They are not inside the nucleus, because inside the nucleus, the strong nuclear force is keeping only the quarks together. It will not act upon the lepton, which is the electron, which is a lepton. Fine. So friends, this was the basic introduction of elementary particles. So we would wind it up here. Okay. Thank you for your time. Take care.